committee as a reason not to further investigate UFOs.
Robert Hastings, in doing all these shows, what confounds me is, if all this is true, what are they afraid of? What's the government afraid of?
Victor Marchetti is a former high-level CIA official. He wrote the book CIA and the Cult of Intelligence in 1975, bestseller. CIA tried to prohibit that being printed. He, Victor Marchetti, in 1979, wrote an article regarding what the CIA thought about UFOs. He alluded to rumors at the agency of crashed UFOs and the recovery of bodies of aliens. More to the point, Victor Marchetti said that, in his view as an intelligence analyst, he thinks that the power structures, the elite, the status quo people in every country on Earth who are in on the secret are really trying to maintain their own power and status and don't want to rock the boat.
Email from Christian, Brighton, Colorado. When is the Air Force going to stop lying to the people and finally tell them the truth about alien visitation? The American people are paying their salaries, and they are supposed to defend and respect the Constitution of the United States of America. Bob Jameson, do you think we'll ever see it? Do you think we'll ever see an Air Force official, Secretary of the Air Force, come on and say, here's the story?
Perhaps through more programs such as this, we can get the public tuned to the fact that there are UFOs. They're not going to hurt you, I don't think. They haven't hurt anybody that I know of. And I think that perhaps through more programs such as yours and such as these people are bringing out.
And a government investigation.
And
open investigation.
There's never been one, right?
Right.
Not really, no. I mean, in 1968 was the last congressional hearing on UFOs. 1968.
40 years.
40 years. We need another one. We need a strong one. Hopefully the next administration will do that.
There's been a lot of behind-the-scenes manipulation of Congress by the military liaison personnel.
Because of what? Fear of what?
Well, again, Larry, these gentlemen are talking about nuclear missiles being dropped offline. The Pentagon does not want the Russians or previously the Soviets to know that. It's going on in the Soviet Union, as Bob Salas said. But I have interviewed persons who are involved with Minuteman missile bases in the 60s, 70s, 80s, and 90s, and they say this is continuing to occur. I've actually interviewed a gentleman a year ago who said that his missiles were activated by UFO, and I described that in detail in my book. I asked him to come on this program, and he declined, I think, because he's uneasy about talking publicly.
There are skeptics, not a surprise. Bill Nye, the science guy, is here when Larry King Live returns.
It does not contain any pattern of purpose or of consistency.
It was not a weather balloon, nor an aircraft, nor a missile. It was something else.
I don't know what they saw in 47, but I'm quite sure it probably was Project Mogul.
Nothing we had at the time could fit the description, size, shape.
Joining our panel is Bill Nye, the science guy. He's a scientist, engineer, best-selling author, and Emmy-winning television personality. He's, by the way, a member of the Skeptic Society and a fellow with the Committee for Skeptical Inquiry. Now, Bill, assuming that these distinguished gentlemen are not lying, we have three former members of the Air Force and Robert Hastings, who's looked into this for a long time. What's your thought?
Well, in the skeptical world, in science, we look at claims. We look at individual claims. So I noticed that we looked at the intro of your show and stuff, that there's several UFO incidents all mixed together. But let's talk about the one in 1967, right? This is your problem,
right?
At Malmstrom Air Force in Montana. So the nuclear missiles went down, right? So if you go look at the documents that these guys have offered, if I understand it, as evidence, you look at some, and you don't have to look, read it, but you see there's something blacked out, okay? Redacted. That's a guy's home address. They don't want you to publish your home address. Here's one with a whole bunch of people's office phone numbers and stuff, and it looks spooky and scary. Well, it looks spooky and scary. But it turns out that that day, or the day before, the power had gone out in some of the chiller units, the air conditioning, okay? And Boeing was called out. Boeing makes a Minuteman missile because all of these things went down.
So the man who called him and said he saw something outside, he didn't see something.
Well, let me just say, when you see something, a lot of people see something. And a lot of people see things that are really they can't identify, but that doesn't mean they were. It's quite a leap.
So you're saying it's a coincidence. This guy thought he saw something, and the missiles go off.
And then you talk to people who are there, and it's very compelling. And these documents, address that one of the officers suspected that somebody had been drinking. Okay.
I never heard that. So I never heard that claim that anybody was drinking. Let me say first of all, the missile shutdowns had nothing to do with power failure. There is triple redundancy on power. We've got Montana power, we've got backup generator, we've got batteries. Okay, the power.
You've never seen missiles go down due to a power failure.
Not really, because of all that backup on power. So this had nothing to do with power. Second point, the flight security guard that reported this was about less than 100 feet away from this object. He was looking at it through his window. It was right outside the front gate, right above the gate. It was glowing red object, pulsing. And that.
Okay, did you see it?
No, I couldn't. I couldn't leave the capsule. But within seconds after that report, the missile shut down. Now, was that a coincidence? Yeah.
Well, it's hearsay, as we say.
It's not hearsay.
Well, you're saying that this guy told you.
Well, you're not saying. I'm not asking you. You don't think he's lying.
No.
All right, so the guy did tell him.
He did tell him, and he saw something. And coincidentally, the missile shut down.
Coincidentally, isn't that a weird coincidence?
Yeah. I mean, I've flipped a light switch and
what
you
if
hear
the
a
same,
siren.
I mean, what if the same thing happened a week earlier? Only this time, 10 missiles go down. A lot of security guards see the UFOs right above the
or five other missile bases.
Okay, so
on
why haven't we?
Cases.
Is that a coincidence too? I mean,
so
you combine 50, the two.
60,
are those
70s,
two
and 80s.
Well,
there's over 100 people.
Not,
Bill.
Well, in science, it's
I
not
wish,
evidence.
I wish Edgar Mitchell were here, but in any case,
it may not be evidence. Let's say, but it is
well,
certainly
100
a source
people are
of
telling the same story at different Air Force bases over a 40-year period.
We saw.
Are they, these guys were entrusted
one
with weapons of destruction by the U.S. government, and there's 100 now are coming forward and saying UFO shut down their nuclear weapons.
Well,
we have mass psychosis
in the interest
among
of time,
nuclear missile forces.
In the interest of time, Dr. Jacobs, he takes pictures, he comes back, they call him in, they show him the pictures
I
of this
saw it,
strange
I'm an
thing.
Eyewitness.
He saw it,
I'm
he
not
saw
talking about
it, and they confiscated.
Yeah.
Why?
I wouldn't be surprised.
Hello?
Go ahead.
Yeah, go ahead.
You mind if I speak, Mr. Comedian?
Go ahead.
I was there. I saw the film with my own eyes. I'm not lying. Why would I? I'm a university professor with a PhD and a lot of years of good, respectful research. So the guys from Officer may not have seen the UFO, but they saw the results of it. I saw the damn thing on film with my own eyes, so don't call me a liar, and you weren't there. I was.
With all due respect, not calling you a liar, it's just quite a step to say there was a film with remarkable images on it that the CIA confiscated.
Which I
it's
saw and which they did.
Yeah, which is quite a step from there to say it was definitely a spacecraft from another civilization. That's the leap
it was,
that the skeptical
it was,
community is reluctant to take.
Hey, pal, listen to me. I didn't say it was a spaceship from another civilization. I said it was something in the air that we couldn't identify. Therefore, it was an unidentified flying object. It was shaped like two saucers put together with a golf ball on top, and it fired a beam that we assumed was a plasma beam at a dummy warhead and knocked it out of space. Tell me what happened. Tell me who did that. Tell me in 1964, who had that technology, pal? Not us, and not the Russians, and nobody I know of.
So
come on,
what's
Mr.
your
skeptic,
conclusion?
What about it?
Well, so what's your conclusion?
What's your conclusion?
What are you saying? Well, my conclusion is that something happened that you don't know what it was, and I wouldn't be surprised if it had something to do with another aspect of military testing in the sky that night. And it's a much more reasonable explanation.
We had nothing. There was nothing in our inventory that could.
So let's do this other little thought experiment, everybody. Okay, let's say this has been going on since 1967, routinely, right? There's an old joke in broadcasting.
Are you going to do this with baking soda and vinegar, Bill?
Hold on. We're running out of time.
It's an old joke in broadcasting.
What is it?
Well, it's like trying to photograph a car wreck. At one time, considered an impossible thing to do. If you send out a news crew, let's go shoot a car wreck. That was a joke. Well, now, routinely on the nightly news, we see car wrecks. We see car wrecks on the freeway. We see car wrecks behind us.
Why was it a joke?
Because there didn't used to be a camera everywhere. There are millions and millions of cameras. There are billions of digital pictures taken every week.
You're not saying there are no UFOs. You're saying that haven't been proven.
I'm saying that it's quite a step to see something you don't know what it is in the sky, to say that there are alien spacecraft.
You got to understand Dr. Jacobs.
That are monitoring our nuclear weapons.
Dr. Jacobs.
Well, I understand that.
Now, so if you're questioning what he's seen,